G'day. Did you know that motorbike stunt riders actually use trigonometry to plan jumps like this? Did you know that you can calculate the height of a mountain without climbing? And did you know that you could use trigonometry to find the width of this waterfall without getting wet? But you don't have to do stunts to use trigonometry. The three trigonometry rules are used in designing machines, buildings, and so much more. But trigonometry is not new. It's the mathematics of right-angled triangles and was invented by mathematicians over 4,000 years ago. Actually, the word trigonometry is Greek. Tri means three. Gon means a shape. And metri means measure. So trigonometry is used to calculate the sizes of the sides and the angles in right-angled triangles. Those clever ancient mathematicians recognised that the size of the angle in a right-angled triangle is related to the ratio of other sides of the triangle. In fact, ancient mathematicians did calculations for every size of angle in a right-angled triangle and for the ratios of the pairs of sides of those triangles. To make it easier for us, though, these ratios are available in a table like this. Or more easily accessed using just three buttons on a calculator, like this. Trigonometry uses three rules. And using just these three rules, we can calculate the size of any side or any angle in right-angled triangles when only two of the measurements of the triangle are actually known. Either we might know one angle and one side, or we might know the measurement of two sides. But before I show you the three trigonometry rules, let's see the important parts of a right-angled triangle. Here is the right angle. It's 90 degrees. Opposite the right angle is the longest side of the triangle that we call the hypotenuse. This angle is marked with the Greek symbol theta. Theta is actually the Greek letter T and is used to mark the angle. Opposite the angle marked theta is the opposite side because it's opposite the theta angle. And right next to the theta angle is the adjacent side. The word adjacent means right next to, because the adjacent side is right next to the theta angle. Right-angled triangles come in all different shapes and in all different positions, so let's practice these before we see the rules. In this right-angled triangle, the right angle and the theta angle have been marked already. Let's identify the hypotenuse that is opposite the right angle. We'll write H for hypotenuse. Now for the opposite side, which is opposite the theta angle, we'll write O for opposite side. The adjacent side is adjacent or right next to the theta angle. We'll write A for adjacent side. In this right angle triangle, the right angle and the theta angle have already been marked. The hypotenuse is opposite the right angle. Here's H for hypotenuse. The opposite side is opposite the theta angle. Here's O for opposite side. And the adjacent side is right next to the theta angle. Here's A for adjacent side. Okay, now we're ready to see the three trigonometry rules. They are ratios that compare the sizes of sides. The first rule is a sine rule. The sine of the angle marked theta is the ratio or the fraction of the size of the opposite side divided by the hypotenuse. That's a lot of writing, so the rule is abbreviated to sine theta equals O divided by H. The second rule is the cosine rule. The cosine of the angle marked theta is the ratio or the fraction of the size of the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. The rule is abbreviated to cos theta equals A divided by H. The third rule is the tangent rule. The tangent of the angle marked theta is the ratio or the fraction of the size of the opposite side divided by the adjacent side. The rule is abbreviated to tan theta equals O divided by A. Here's a quick trick to remember these rules. Sokotoa. S-O-H-C-A-H-T-O-A. It's not a word, it's a quick way to remember the three rules like this. Sine theta equals opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Cos theta equals adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. And tan theta equals the opposite side divided by the adjacent side. Sokotoa. Now this video is just an introduction. There are three other videos called Sine Rule, Cosine Rule and Tangent Rule with lots of tips and examples on how to do trigonometry in real life situations. Thank you for watching this video.